Are we going to start like right away? Hey, I said.
What's up?
Hey, I said.
What's up?
Hey, I said.
What's up?
That's good. Okay, so today I'm going to share with you here my I said journey. I am originally from I said Singapore and I live in Costa Rica. Do you know where Costa Rica is?
Yes.
Where is it?
South.
Where?
South
America? Then? Central America. Very good. So, here in India, South America and Central America are two different continents. And I said belong in. Costa Rica is part of Central America. Who is going to move the slides? Can I move the computer here? Maybe I can move it. Recently featured in the Isaac International's 75th anniversary storybook. I think I have crossed all the boundaries of Isaac exchange programs. I'm yet to meet another person who has done as many or as long Isaac internships as I did. I made Isaac my lifestyle. And I'm going to share my journey with you and how I'm here today. Can we have the next slide, please? Yeah, so a little bit about who am I. Further. Yeah, so I am a globetrotter. I have not just traveled, but lived from Asia to Europe, to Africa, to South America, North and Central America with local people doing ISEC exchange programs. And during this time, I have had so many magical experiences that I wrote a whole book about it. This book has all the magical, 21 magical stories from my travels across the world, which was enabled by ISEC. And by magic, I mean real magic, where there were moments where I felt I was having a real two-way communication with the universe, and sometimes I found myself in life-threatening situations. Sometimes I found myself like stuck in places where there was no way to come out, and then magically I was saved. And of course this magic was coming from inside of me that I know now. And I'm going to share those insights with you, because these kind of exchange programs and traveling across the world makes you life intelligent. What do I mean by that? You develop skills. You expand the horizon of your thinking. And no matter what challenge life throws at you, you can always overcome them. That's the power of ISEC exchange programs. So, without further ado, I'm going to move straight into my presentation. Let's move. More. Just go all the way down. Yeah, till here. So, these are all the ISEC LC countries where I have been associated with. More than a globetrotter, I call myself a compulsive ISECer. Because I still am an ISECer, and I'm doing events all over the world. I travel to countries. I am invited to speak and present the journey in my book, and without ISEC, I couldn't have done it. So I started my ISEC journey in Singapore. I did my university in Singapore on a scholarship, and just like today, I'm standing here in front of you, talking about my experience. There was a conference in Singapore that I attended, which motivated me so much to join ISEC. And those days we used to have interviews to be able to go exchange programs. And I was in my final semester at university, and the interviews for that semester were already over. So just when I figured out what I really wanted to do in life, that is travel through ISEC, the door was shut on my face. And there was no way I could join ISEC, and I was graduating the following semester. Until about a month later, the president of ISEC at my university, NUS in Singapore, called me and said, hey, there is an interview happening in Malaysia. Do you want to go there and to give the interview? And she didn't know that I was an Indian, a foreign student in Singapore, and I needed a visa to go to Malaysia, which the Singaporeans don't need. But coincidentally or synchronistically or via some divine intervention, I had just gotten a Malaysian visa just the previous semester during a conference that I was organizing, and I had a Malaysian visa, so I could travel to Malaysia, give my interview, then I got selected, and after that I traveled all over the world, Asia, to Europe, to Africa, to South America, to North and Central America, doing ISEC exchange programs. So, can we move forward? So, I am an ISECer, and I am now going to talk a little bit about my ISEC exchange programs. Move forward, please. Yeah. So, my first internship was in ISEC Nigeria. I worked at the capital, Abuja, at the Nigeria Model United Nations. And then I worked at ISEC Lagos, and I was working with a TV show called Goge Africa, and they make like TV shows about African culture and the diaspora, which is screened like all over Africa. So mind you, I graduated at university in computer engineering, and after graduation, I felt like this is not exactly what I want to do in life, and what I wanted to do, I had no clue. Then ISEC was my inner compass that guided me here. I was doing something totally different, a bit like voluntary internships and management internships. It was a mix of both. And I lived in Africa for 1.5 years, and I have some really magical stories from Africa. If we have time at the end, I will share one or two with you here. Let's move. I have very little time, so I am going to run. My next ISEC exchange was in South America, in Venezuela. I was in the city called Maracaibo, and I was teaching English and business communication at the Wall Street Institute there, and Centro Venezolano Americano del Zulia. This is the largest English language institution in Maracaibo. And I did these two exchanges for 2 years in South America. And during my exchange programs, we had other ISECers from other countries. There were ISECers from Poland and Mexico and Netherlands and Belgium and US and Canada and Guatemala and Africa, like all countries. And whenever we would have vacations, we would all get together and go traveling in groups. I think those were the most fun parts. We never had enough money to travel, but you know, we lived in backpackers' lodges, and we hiked across the South American exotic landscapes, and we created so many memories, so many adventures that, you know, I cannot do justice to them with words. You just have to experience them to know what it really feels like. Move forward. My final exchanges were in Costa Rica, where I worked. I was a global exchange, global talent there, and I was selected through ISEC in Germany. I worked at Deutsche Post, DHL. And I taught English and business communication to the supervisors and managers there. And then I also worked at Centro Cultural Costarricense Norteamericano. and the entire duration of the actual exchange was 3 years. And during these exchanges, I was writing down all the magical experiences that I was having, that if I hadn't written down in those moments, they would have been lost forever. And during my final exchange in Costa Rica, I published my first book, which is called Magic Nine, because I really had a lot of magical experiences at the time. And then I got a permanent residency in Costa Rica. I was offered, I took it, because I really liked this country. So you see, Isaac knew where to place me. For me now, when I look back, I think it was destiny. Yeah, so during my exchange programs, just move. The picture in the background is me swimming inside the crater of a volcano, a dormant volcano in Costa Rica. Just the light background. Yeah, so I was eating the food of the local families there in Africa. I lived with an African family in Venezuela. I lived with a Venezuelan family. When I first went there, I didn't even know hello in Spanish. And they didn't know hello in English. And we communicated with each other through gestures and symbols until I picked up the language like a little child picks up its mother tongue by listening to the adults around it. And I never took a Spanish class. I never went to a Spanish language institution or grammar classes, but today I'm also a Spanish translator and I have a bilingual blog. I have lots of videos on YouTube in Spanish and of course in English and Bengali, Hindi, all languages, German. So another perk of going on exchanges is actually picking up a language and speaking it fluently. Please go on, just go to the end of this slide. Yeah, so during this time I was eating their food, I was inhabiting their culture, their religion, I was wearing their costumes, the local costumes, I was contributing to their economy by working and serving in those countries, serving the locals. I was negotiating extreme realities and belief systems. Sometimes you find yourself in places that will shock you. Some cultures that I was at were just dangerous. They were just ridiculous compared to the culture that I was brought up in. And my experience of myself in those moments were like, how do I make sense of life? What does all this mean to me? And there were many existential questions that came up. I was always navigating very dangerous circumstances because I chose some of the most dangerous countries in the world to do my exchange. I don't know why, but maybe it was, those were the places I was meant to be, like in Venezuela. They shoot you before they loot you. And you know what? I was very young, your age, and I learned how to protect myself. I was alone. There was nobody to protect me. Nobody walks the streets of Maracaibo, where I lived, and I didn't have money, so I often walked. And I would meet people, shady characters, but somehow I had learned a way to protect myself, to communicate with a charisma that even someone who might have bad intentions towards me, his intentions would change to something positive. I don't know what it was, but having these extreme experiences, I felt that there was some higher energy that was protecting me on these trips. And there were moments where I was just stuck in situations that I had no way to come out. And something so magical would happen that my faith in the universe or in God or in cosmos, whatever you want to call it, just increased multifold. And the more that happened, the signs and the synchronicities and the magical encounters in my life multiplied. And I want to share those experiences with you here. That's why I wrote this book. And these are not just, I said, exchange stories, but they also teach you how you can go to that level of consciousness where you can navigate any reality, where you can escape any disease, where you can escape any dangerous situation. Wouldn't you want to live that kind of a reality? Yes. So I'm going to share a little more. Please move on. Yeah, so I'm standing on the ashes of an active volcano in Costa Rica. You can see I'm flying. I'm literally flying. At university, I had a crippling back injury that had made me want to take my own life. And from there, I used to have a dream every night that I was flying. And during university, I couldn't even move from one point to another without feeling intense pain in my back. And after 2.5 years of suffering, I didn't want to live that life anymore. Then something magical happened. One by one, Isaac came into my life, and it literally took me across the world and made my dreams come true, where my dream was to fly. Move. From a conservative family background, I come from one of the most conservative parents who didn't even allow me to go out alone on the streets. From a conservative family background in India, I had to overcome all limiting beliefs that were inside me, that were holding me back from living my dream life, and cultural prejudices to fly in the direction of my dreams. Move. Yeah, so quickly, the salient features of my ISET journey. 10+ years, 5 continents, 6 exchanges, 1 global exchange at Deutsche Post brought value to thousands of lives during my exchange programs. I published my first book on ISET exchange, my second book published, Life is Abracadabra, and my third book is on the roll, which I want to make into a feature film. I became an award-winning international speaker. I just want to tell you that in Costa Rica and Latin America, I speak at par with the country presidents, world leaders, and world visionaries. And you will see some. I am also a TED speaker. I have lots of 6 TEDx talks that you can watch on YouTube. In fact, I gave a talk, TEDx talk, about ISET, which is called How to Travel the World at the Drop of a Hat. So you can watch that TED talk, which I did here in India, and that talk is all about ISET. And I have extraordinary insights to impart, and currently I am impacting ISETers with my work. Move, please. So in my world, not only has ISET changed my life, shaping the person I am today as an author, speaker, performer, from a confused computing student in Singapore trying to make sense of reality. But it has also helped me discover my passion and purpose. From a computing graduate to a marketing executive to a German interpreter, English teacher, Spanish translator, to now a writer, orator, dancer, actor. Mysterious coincidences led me from one continent to another, contriving me to live my destiny and to leave a legacy. I have the opportunity to positively impact and inspire thousands of lives across the world during my ISET exchanges, and my latest book, Life is Abracadabra, is a collection of magical stories and marvelous encounters from these adventures, recounting true anecdotes of hope and faith, of magic and miracles, with an entire story dedicated to ISET. Move on, please. Yeah, move on. So I did, during my ISEF exchange programs, I did volunteering internships, educational internships, management internships, and now it's your turn. Move on. So some life's idiosyncrasies I want to share with you. Please move. This is what I discovered through my ISEF journey, that what is right in one culture is wrong in another culture. What is polite in one country is rude in another country. What is respectful in one region is disrespectful in another region. What you think is good, someone else thinks it's bad. And sometimes the nonsense makes the best sense. And at the end of it, I realized that we are making it all up. There is no absolute truth. There is no absolute culture. There is no absolute religion or belief system. We are making it up as we go, and if we encounter dysfunctional cultures, dysfunctional belief systems, we can change it in our imaginations, in our minds, create new cultures that will serve us. Because in the end, after seeing all kinds of religions, all kinds of traditions and culture, I realized there must be something higher than all those definitions that we put ourselves into boxes when we come into this world. And if we can step outside those boxes, outside those definitions of religions and traditions and culture and societal expectations, then we will be ready to experience what I call real magic, the abracadabra kind of magic. Move on. So you suspend your beliefs and you can turn your biggest fear into your greatest glory. So that's my message. Move on, please. And through these travels, all you need to do is expand the horizon of your thinking. The larger you can think, the more of yourself, the more of your soul you let in, and the more magic you can create in your lives. And that is your soul desire here on earth. So this is the path to passion and purpose, and it was for me. Move on. And passion is what defines you. So no matter what you do, you have to keep the passion in your life alive. And I say this path is written, but you are writing it. You are the creator and the creative of your own life. And this is the way of the dreamers. You know, ISEFers are dreamers. Move on. So towards the end of my presentation, I want to ask you, do you have a dream? If you don't, create a dream and make sure that your dream is so big that it scares you. If it doesn't, then it is not a real dream. It has to be something unreachable, something infinite. You start the dream here in your imagination. You believe in your dream, and then the universe starts responding to it, starts sending you opportunities. You have to recognize the opportunity. It may be very subtle, but when it comes, your soul will know, this is what I have been waiting for. And then you go in that direction, you will be guided on your path. Move on. So this was for me the ISEF dream. It was the path of the heart against the path of others' expectations of me. You know, when I went to Africa, I had just graduated, and my parents were vehemently opposed to that idea. I'm talking about 15 years back. And at the time, there were no Google Maps, there were no smartphones, no Uber Ola. We used to just buy the map, a physical map of a country, a Lonely Planet guidebook. And that's how we used to travel. We didn't have something telling me where is the next restaurant or where is the next hotel, you know. And nowadays traveling has become so much easier. There are so many influencers and bloggers that are inspiring people to travel. So you must take this opportunity. ISEF helps you do everything. And all you have to do, even if it is for a short term, you don't have to do it for as long as I did. But whether you go on a short term internship or long term internships, you must explore the world where you have been put by God or some divine power that you take. And only when you know the world truly, having seen it, then you can become a master of the world. And you will experience meaningful coincidences, magical opportunities, chance encounters, which I experienced during these intense travels. And at the end of it, I realized that I was unsinkable. No matter what happens, I can never sink. And I was unstoppable. And I want to emit this same energy to you all. You will graduate very soon and you will go out there into the world and you will need inspiration. So always remember, no matter what happens, no matter what challenge is presented in front of you, your soul is ready for it, because if you weren't, you wouldn't be experiencing that challenge. So know that God has put this challenge in front of me because I have the capacity to overcome it. Move on. So this is the abracadabra way, a story of which dreams are made of. In Hebrew, abracadabra means I shall create as I speak. I shall create. What happened? I shall create as I believe, and I shall create as I do. Yeah, and all of this life is a creation, and you are a creator born in the image and likeness of the divine. And you are here to experience and express that divine power within you. And you do that with your imagination. Move on, please. Just skip this slide. Here I have some tips for dreamers. You have to dream big, you have to build your castles in the air, then you put the foundation. You have to take inspired action, go the distance, travel, build your dreams, self-express, make merry, follow your passion, never quit dreaming, and paint your masterpiece in this lifetime. So that's my book, Life is Abracadabra. We are very fortunate that my publisher, Hay House and Penguin, has brought only a few books. There are only 40 books here, and we have there Satish, who is from Penguin International. Here, some books. Believe you me, when you read this book, your entire perspective of life will change. So there are only 40 books. First come, first serve basis. Anybody who gets the book, I think he is also giving a big discount of 20% or something like that. The actual book costs 400, and the 20% discount, it will come to some 320. So grab it. You can get it signed while I'm still here. Tomorrow I'm going back to Costa Rica. So today is my last day in India, and I'm very happy to be sharing these moments with all you enthusiastic young people who are full of dreams and hope for a better life. Just move on. Yeah, move on, please. Go on. If anybody has a question or a comment or wants to share something, you can do it, but move forward, please. There is a video, short video here about my ISAC journey, but I don't know if you will have. Okay, you can see this video later, maybe in the break you can play it. Just move forward. So I just want to name some famous ISACers who created history very quickly. Kofi Annan, you all must know him. He was the Secretary General of the United Nations, and he was an ISACer. Next, Savaco Silva, President of Portugal, was an ISACer. Hello? Yeah. Mario Monti, former Prime Minister of Italy, he was an ISEC. See, ISEC really opens your mind. It opens possibilities, it opens a new dimension. So, yeah. John Kerry, current Secretary of State of the US, he was an ISEC-er. Micheline Kalni-Ray, Federal Counselor of Switzerland, she was an ISEC-er. Alexander Kwasniewski, President of Poland, was an ISEC-er. Bill Clinton, President of the US, ex-president, was an ISEC-er. And Mick Jagger, lead singer, Rolling Stones, is an ISEC alumni. Move on. Yeah, there is one slide that is missing. Let me just say, just the last. Can you come out, show me all the slides? Let's go down.
Wait. ran.
I don't know.
Oh, she's taking a free after a date.